you know, be a part of a short film and a full-length feature film?
Firstly, good afternoon. Thank you all for coming. To answer your question, being a part of any film as an actor, I think is amazing. As long as you love the script and you want to tell a story. The only difference between a full-length feature film and a short film as this is, like Niranjan said, you're telling different stories. Some stories lend itself beautifully to 12 minutes, 15 minutes, and some need an hour and a half. This film lent itself beautifully to 15, 30 minutes, 12 minutes that we had. And when he narrated the script to me, I thought it was pretty much layered. And I remember when we did the readings, there was so much that came out, because I don't know if you realize, but Ma has different perspectives. There's a mother's perspective, there's an older brother's perspective, and there's a younger brother's perspective on life. So it's all gray. There's no black and white, because what she does is right, what I do is right, and what he feels is good for him is right too. So there's no right and wrong, like the end line says, there's no right and wrong. Those decisions about life are made. So as an actor, yes, for me performing, and I haven't done a film in a few years, so when Niranjan brought this to me, I was very excited to be in front of the camera again. So as an actor, whether it's a short film or a full-length feature film, love playing a role.
Okay, Vivan, so your role was very challenging. Tell us about your experience in the movie. Like, how was it to be a part of the short film, Ma?
It was a real blast. We had so much fun working together. All of us became so close, you know. It was just 2 days, but it felt as if, like, we've, you know, had a journey together. And it was really amazing. Like, and I learned so much working with everyone, working with all of them. And also, the role to play a heroin addict, I think I remember, like, once this interview of John Travolta where he spoke about how he prepared, because in Pulp Fiction he played a heroin addict. So he said that somebody told him he went to meet a heroin junkie, and he said, obviously I can't actually do heroin to know how it feels like. So the guy told him, have a lot of tequila, have like, finish one bottle of tequila and lie in a bathtub, you'll get somewhat of a feeling what heroin feels like. So I didn't do that, but I used my imagination.
Vivan, tell the truth. Vivan got into the role and got into the character. Abhi sach batao.
No, it's true. I couldn't have actually injected myself with heroin. No, it was so much fun, yeah. And it was interesting to play a heroin addict. It's a really unusual character.
Okay, the floor is now open for questions from the media. Would anybody like to ask anything?
I'm loud enough. So I just wanted to find out everybody's experiences and the thought process, and what did you go through while going through a movie, because I've come across people who said that it really affected them somewhere and they felt it. So what was your kind of a feeling when you were doing it as a mother, as a brother, and as obviously the addict? Sorry, I'm telling it that way.
You want to start from there?
It was a very cathartic experience. I think the film also, and in fact on the big screen, the emotion that registers from the film, it really hits you. It's quite emotionally harrowing. And I showed it to my parents and they were really disturbed by it. Like, especially mothers. I think all mothers, whenever they watch the film, it takes them some time to recover from it, because it is really difficult. Like, it was a cathartic experience working on the film.
My experience. Well, when we were doing readings before shooting the film, it actually opened my mind up a little more as to, like I said earlier, the perspectives. Because everyone has a perspective. I tell my mother that I've been taking care of my younger brother, I know his life, and he's happy. But if he goes in for a treatment, that's going to be ridiculous. Once the movie was made, I showed it to my parents, and my brother saw it too. And my mother's perspective was like how we discussed. She said, yeah, I'll do anything for my son to live, even if it's a treatment which we don't know what the results could be, but I'll do that. But my younger brother, who saw the film, and said, but why? He's happy. Why does he need treatment? He's happy the way he is, and he cannot, nothing can help him right now. He's in a happy space in his own world. So I think that's a better way to live than go through what he went through. So like I said, there's no right and wrong. Everyone has a perspective and a decision. Yes, so getting into the film was a process which we went through, and you know, you just have to go through the emotions while you're acting it out. And working with these two was just unbelievable. And of course, Niranjan, his debut, what a fantastic one.
Yeah, it was a tough role for me because I had to really I internalize a lot, and I had the script earlier before me. I used to keep troubling Niranjan, call him up and say, I don't agree with this, and how do we get into that? And till I said, I have to just internalize the whole thing and just think for myself, because I'm a mom of two, and they're as old as these people, and I just have to just hypothetically think about this thing, you know. So I did internalize. I think after internalizing what came out, what I liked about myself, I'm very critical about what I do. I never liked myself on screen. But here, I thought the hard look that I had got worked for it, because she couldn't be too much of a softy, you know. She only softens up with the younger son. But that hard look, I felt, okay. All that prepping that I did, internal prepping, it came out well. So, you know, mothers have a hard choice, and one thing I've learned from this film, I must tell you, Niranjan, is that now after I did this and after I saw it at various places earlier, before this release, you know, or even on when he sent me the first cut, I look at my children differently now. They're old, I mean, they're as old as Dino and Vivan, but I look at their choices and what I would be telling them to do differently. I don't know whether they have realized it, but they were both quite kicked about the movie when they saw it. So they were like, oh my God, this is like, they really liked it. They called up Niranjan and they discussed it and they agreed and disagreed. So I think any film that, you know, evokes so much of reaction, pro, con, whether, just a thought process, just make you think. I think that film's a hit.
How was it to write? What was the thought process?
Well, I think I've always grappled with the sense of right and wrong that we are constantly, thrown into in our lives, whether it is culturally, whether it is through literature, or whether it is through our upbringing. I've always wondered that when people say this is the right thing to do and this is a wrong thing to do, how sure are they about it? You know, most often we get into decisions and then sometimes, and most times actually, we define whether a thing was right or wrong on the basis of the results that have happened. If the result is good, then it was the right thing to do. If the results are bad, then it's a wrong thing to do. So it's always I've always wondered about this. So when I decided to write it, to be honest, when I started writing this film, all the layers were all subconscious. What I was looking at was a storyline with a punch. And for me, that was really great. My biggest moment while I was writing the film was the moment when I realized that he's an artist who paints so beautifully earlier, and when after the surgery, he does stick figures for his mother. When I got that device, I knew that I'd arrived at something interesting, and I arrived at something that I wanted to say without being preachy. So when I got that, then everything else was then layering as I wrote it. So I think I wrote the first draft in about 20 minutes of this film, and it took me about 3 weeks to polish it and fully layer it. Then of course I started discussions with Nina firstly, because she was a central character, and there were a lot of questions that she raised when I spoke to her also. So then I had to address those questions. Then according to me, though, I mean, Nina's part is Ma and Vivan's is the in that sense, the toughest part for me to write, and I think even for him to perform, was Dino's. Because both of them are extremes. One is taking the decisions and going through with it, so she's a risk taker. The other one is a so-called victim, if you have to put it. It's the balancer who always has a problem in any narrative, because a balancer is somebody who doesn't have any dramatic moment, who doesn't have something concrete to say which can impact you immediately. It's only when you go back home, and that's why I was most worried about Dino's character throughout the film, because I knew that Nina is a great actress, she would do it, and also her part was written in a way where there were dramatic moments, she took the decision, she went into it. Dino's was a part that really needed work in terms of everything had to come together, like performance, writing, shooting, the way I shot it, everything had to go. So I think that was the toughest part for me to write, and I think I wouldn't be wrong if I say that even for him to perform. Because it's very balanced, it's very sincere, it's very normal, and like we all know, real, normal, good people are very boring on screen.
Casting plays a very important part, you know, on what ground you zeroed in the star cast, especially the Ma, you know.
See, the thing is,
Dina is a very good friend of mine, and I've seen her perform for many, many years now. I've seen her plays, and we really hit it off very well. So when I started writing this film, I was very sure no matter what the storyline is, she was going to be Ma. So she was very, very bang on. Dino, actually, I bumped into at a party, and we were having a chat with each other, and I think he said something to me which was very... he said, if there's anything that you think is suitable for me, please let me know. It's not the line, it's the way he said it to me at the party. And immediately I thought, why don't I cast him as the son? Because by then I'd written two drafts of the film. And I said, let me cast him as the son. And once I cast these two, I needed somebody who looked like Dino's brother. So I cast Vivan. I needed somebody who had a physical presence which looked like Dino. In fact, I had very clearly decided, and I told Dino that also, that if Vivan says no to this film, I'm coming to your brother Santino. We'll cast Santino in the film and we'll make this movie. But thankfully, Vivan didn't say no. He said yes to me, and it all worked out. So casting really happened. I didn't have to put too much effort into it.
You know, in a very positive note, you know, how long, you know, after a long period you are there on the screen, yeah. Were you nervous while shooting the very first day? And all, please let me know the duration of the gap between you and the camera.
Well, the duration, firstly, yes, before any shoot I'm very nervous. I'm always nervous, and I think being nervous and having that nervous energy makes you more excited and makes you want to work harder. Fortunately, we did a couple of readings before we started shooting, so it was like a rehearsal. And over the few years, I've always, once a week, I keep updating myself with acting and workshops and stuff. So I'm always prepared. Our workshops helped me prepare more for this particular character and this film. And on day of shooting, I remember the first shot, I was really nervous. Thank God it didn't show on screen. But like I said, that nervous energy is always good, because the minute I feel you're not nervous anymore, then you're bored and you're done. You know, so I feel that nervous energy brings about an excitement within you to perform better and to work harder. During our shoot, I loved it. It was great to be back in front of the camera and to be playing a certain character. Okay. अभी इनसे पूछो ना पतला कैसे हो गया फिल्म के बाद.
Would anybody else like to ask anything?
No, thank you.
अरे यहाँ पे बुला लो
यहीं से कर
ले
यहीं से करो अपनी लाइट
मारेंगे लाइट लगाएंगे
माफी चाहूंगा मैं हिंदी में ही आपसे जवाब चाहूंगा और मेरा जवाब मतलब सवाल दिनू जी से है कि सबसे पहले तो थैंक्स देना चाहूंगा आपने जो फिल्म नशे के ऊपर बनाई है समाज को मैसेज देने के लिए बहुत अच्छी पहल है लेकिन सर मैं एक चीज इसमें और चाहूंगा हम कलाकार लोग समाज को मैसेज देने की मतलब हर संभव कोशिश करते हैं अपनी फिल्मों के माध्यम से अपने जो भी वक्तव्य देते हैं मीडिया में उसके माध्यम से भी हम कहते हैं कि नशा से दूर रहिए नशा गलत है लेकिन कहीं हम देख रहे हैं कि इंडस्ट्री में ज़्यादातर नई जनरेशन हम कलाकारों के बीच में नशे के प्रति बहुत ज़्यादा आकर्षित होती जा रही है हम समाज को मैसेज देने के लिए फिल्म बनाते हैं क्यों ना कोई ऐसी फिल्म या ऐसा मैसेज देने की योजना की जाए जो हम कलाकारों को में भी सुधार आने चाहिए सर प्लीज़ सर
देखिए हम फिल्म बनाते हैं हम हमारी जो इस माध्यम के थ्रू हम कहानी बताते हैं सब लोगों को अगर कुछ लोगों को समझ में आएंगे कि अच्छा ये जो है ये जो मुद्दा है ड्रग्स और इस फिल्म की खासतौर पर इस फिल्म के एक जो स्पेशल मुद्दा है एक माँ और एक बेटा के रिलेशनशिप है हाँ हम बता रहे हैं कि नशा एक बुरी चीज़ है मगर एक ऐसा इंसान है जो उस नशे में बहुत खुश है अपनी दुनिया में खुश है मगर हम वो नहीं बता रहे हम लोग बता रहे हैं कि इन दोनों के बीच में जो रिलेशनशिप है एक माँ का फैसला और एक बड़े भाई का जो फैसला है उसके बारे में हम लोग बता रहे हैं हम ये नहीं बता रहे हैं कि अगर आप ड्रग्स ले रहे हो वो अच्छा है या बुरा है मगर जैसे आप मुझे पूछ रहे हैं कि क्यों ना हम एक ऐसी पिक्चर बनाएं जिसमें हम सबको बताएं कि अगर कलाकार भी ड्रग्स इस्तेमाल करेंगे मैं मानता हूँ कि सिर्फ कलाकार नहीं अगर जो भी इंसान है अगर वो ड्रग्स लेते हैं वो एक बुरी चीज़ है वैसे ये बहुत सारे कैंपेन्स इस तरह के कैंपेन्स भी चल रहे हैं कि से नो टू ड्रग्स तो एक स्पेशली एक फिल्म की ज़रूरत नहीं है क्योंकि सबको जानते हैं इट्स अ पर्सन इंडिविजुअल अंडरस्टैंडिंग whether I should do it or not. हम लोग बनाएंगे पिक्चर या इस तरह की जो पब्लिक कैंपेन लोग मतलब हर पिक्चर से पहले वो एक धूम्रपान का जो एक सोशल मैसेज आता है सब लोग देखते हैं और कहते हैं कि ची 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 मगर कौन रोकता है इट्स अ इंडिविजुअल
अंडरस्टैंडिंग
हम लोग जितनी भी पिक्चर्स बनाएंगे इसके बारे में या जितनी भी पब्लिक कैंपेन्स है अल्टीमेटली इट्स अप टू द इंडिविजुअल टू अंडरस्टैंड कि ये बुरी चीज़ है और हमें नहीं करना
अब आपने तो देखी है फिल्म आपको पता चलेगा कि ये रिश्तों के बारे में है ये समाज के बारे में है हम जो फैसले करते हैं ज़िंदगी में उसके बारे में है सही और गलत के जो मायने होते हैं जो हमें सिखाया जाता है बचपन से उसके बारे में कि क्या हम जो सही और गलत हमेशा चुनते हैं वो हमेशा रिज़ल्ट पे डिपेंडेंट होता है अगर रिज़ल्ट अच्छा हुआ तो फैसला सही और अगर नहीं तो फैसला भी सही नहीं है गलत है तो इस पे मैं सवाल उठा रहा हूँ इस फिल्म के ज़रिए कि जब हम फैसले करते हैं तो उस वक्त किसी को पता नहीं होता कि क्या इसका रिज़ल्ट सही होगा या गलत और फिर हमें उन फैसलों की जिम्मेदारी भी लेनी पड़ती है आगे चल के जैसे कि इस फिल्म में एक माँ ने अपने फैसले की जिम्मेदारी ली है तो इसी पे है फिल्म ये एक रिश्तों की बात है और एक ज़िंदगी के जो सवाल हम में उठते हैं उसके बारे में एक फिल्म जब ब्यूटीफुल आप कहते हैं जब खूबसूरत फिल्म बनती है तो वो सब मिलके बनती है मैं कितनी भी फिल्म खूबसूरत लिखूं अगर बाकी की चीज़ें खूबसूरत नहीं होंगी तो आपको फिल्म खूबसूरत नहीं लगेगी तो अभी आपको ये फिल्म खूबसूरत लग रही है अगर आपको लग रहा है कि ये फिल्म पूरी तरह से एक पूरी फिल्म है तो इसमें सब लोग उतने ही जिम्मेदार हैं जितना मैंने लिखी थी मैंने डायरेक्ट की लेकिन अगर इन लोगों का साथ नहीं होता तो ये फिल्म इतनी खूबसूरत नहीं होती तो जब आप कहते हैं कि कोई चीज़ खूबसूरत है तो उसकी हर बात उसका हर पहलू खूबसूरत होता है तो ये कास्ट भी खूबसूरत है और जैसे मैंने बताया थोड़ी देर पहले कि नीना मेरी दोस्त है तो मैंने जब लिखते वक्त ये तय कर लिया था कि माँ का रोल तो नीना ही करेगी कि डीनो मुझे पार्टी में मिले उनसे मेरी बातचीत हुई मैंने कहा कि अच्छा ये इस रोल के लिए सूटेबल है तो मैं इनके पास जाऊँगा अब इन्होंने मेरी खुशनसीबी की हाँ कह दिया इन्होंने हाँ कह दिया फिर मैंने सोचा कि डीनो के छोटे भाई का रोल उनकी तरह दिखने वाला कोई चाहिए विवान को था पृथ्वी थिएटर के दिनों से तो उसको कास्ट कर लिया तो इसी तो फिल्में ऐसे ही बनती हैं और एक कंफर्ट एक अंडरस्टैंडिंग होती है लोगों में आपको ये भी पता होता है कि हम जब किसी को कास्ट कर रहे हैं तो खास तौर पे पहली फिल्म में ये बहुत ज़रूरी होता है कि हम सिर्फ उन्हीं लोगों को कास्ट करें जिनके साथ एक ट्यूनिंग हो
जी।
ताकि फिर मैं जो चीज़ बताना चाहूँ बेझिझक उनको बता सकूँ या उनकी कोई प्रॉब्लम होगी तो वो मुझसे बेझिझक कह सकें तो ये हमारी रिलेशनशिप थी तो मैंने अपने दोस्तों को कास्ट कर लिया और बना ली
अच्छा आप तीनों से सवाल जब ये स्क्रिप्ट आई देखा जाए तो फिर क्या खास बात लगा कि आपको लगा कि ये करनी चाहिए
पहली बात तो वो जो रोल है जिससे मैं बहुत प्रभावित हुई और क्योंकि इस तरह का रोल मुझे ज़्यादा करके नहीं मिला है करने के लिए थिएटर में कर चुकी हूँ ग्रे शेड्स जो आजकल का शब्द है इसलिए इस्तेमाल कर रही हूँ पर इस माँ की जो दुविधा है और वो जिस तरीके से उसको निभाती है उस दुविधा को और अगेन जैसे निरंजन ने कहा कि सही गलत का फैसला हम कौन तय होते हैं तय करने वाले क्या सही है और क्या गलत है तो वो मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा और मुझे ऐसा लगा कि मैं कुछ कर सकती हूँ उस रोल के लिए जब इन्होंने मुझे पूछा तो डेफिनेटली मैंने हाँ कर दी
ओके डू यू एग्री विद दिस ना जिस तरह फिल्म में दिखाया गया है कि अमूमन जब हम मेट्रो सिटीज की बात करते हैं लोग ज़्यादा करियर ओरिएंटेड होते हैं अब माँ को कहीं कहते हैं कि आपका करियर आपने बना लिया डू यू एग्री विद दिस कि ये एक वजह है कहीं जब हम ड्रग्स की बात करते हैं या बच्चे गलत संगत में आ जाते हैं बहुत अच्छे से दिखाया गया उसको प्रिंट आउट
आजकल जो अर्बन जिंदगी है अर्बन सिटीज में इस तरह की सिचुएशंस होते रहते हैं बिकॉज कभी कभार माँ बिजी होती रहती है काम पे और बच्चे निगलेक्ट हो जाते हैं और इस फिल्म में मैं इनकी देखभाल कर रहा था और जब माँ आई बाद में काफ़ी सालों के बाद तो मैं इनसे कहता हूँ कि आप तो बहुत बिजी थे अभी तो फ्री हो चुकी है तो इट हैपन्स इन टूडेज सिचुएशंस इसलिए मैं कह रहा हूँ कि हर एक का पर्सपेक्टिव है हर एक का अलग अलग पर्सपेक्टिव है एक माँ की तरफ से एक पर्सपेक्टिव होती है कि शी थिंक शी इज़ राइट हाँ मैं लेट आई मगर आई वॉज वर्किंग टू टेक केयर ऑफ योर एक माँ की पर्सपेक्टिव है एक बेटा की जो पर्सपेक्टिव है वो कहते हैं कि यार माँ कभी नहीं थी वो बिजी रहती थी बट वी डोंट अंडरस्टैंड कि वो काम कर रही थी हमारे लिए
नहीं, और ये भी बात है कि वो सिंगल मदर है, वेरी ऑब्वियसली
जी बिल्कुल,
हां सिंगल मदर की जो प्रॉब्लम्स है तो वो ऑब्वियसली इसका सीक्वल अगर बनेगा या प्रीक्वल अगर बनेगा तो उसमें, लेकिन वो भी बात इसमें है जाहिर कि वो सिंगल मदर है, क्योंकि मैं जब रोल कर रही थी तो मुझे ये दुविधा आई थी कि क्यों क्यों करेगी ऐसा, अगर पति जिंदा होते या नहीं होते उसके पास तो शायद पूरा माहौल ही अलग होता। तो
और सबसे पहली बात ये है कि हम यही जो आप कह रहे हैं कि आपको लगता है ये सही है या गलत है, तो मेरा सबसे पहले ये फिल्म बनाने का जो जो मकसद है वही ये है कि हम ये जो दायरे बनाते हैं सही और गलत के हमारे लिए, वो हमारे आपस के कभी कभी पर्सनल भी होते हैं, और कभी कभी जो चीज़ यूनिवर्सली सही या गलत में बट चुकी होती है वो किसी खास सिचुएशन में अप्लाई नहीं होती। जैसे कि ये जो माँ है वो अकेली माँ है, मेरी बैक स्टोरी के मुताबिक इनके पति ने इनको छोड़ दिया था जब बच्चे बहुत छोटे थे, अब ये बाहर जाकर नौकरी नहीं करती तो ये बच्चों की परवरिश नहीं हो पाती, और इस परवरिश के दौरान जैसा हर इंसान कोई गलती कर सकता है तो शायद उससे थोड़ा बहुत निग्लेक्ट हो गया है बच्चा, लेकिन ये ज़रूरी है कि क्या हर निग्लेक्टेड बच्चा ड्रग्स ही लेता है, क्या हर निग्लेक्टेड बच्चा बुरी संगत में ही फंसता है, या क्या निग्लेक्टेड घरों से बच्चे आगे चल के बड़े नहीं बनते, ये भी तो सवाल हैं। तो हम ये सवाल नहीं करते, हम सिर्फ यही सवाल करते कि उसने निग्लेक्ट कर दिया तो बच्चा ड्रग एडिक्ट होगा। ये जो दायरे हम बनाते हैं, इन दायरों को तोड़ने की मेरी ये छोटी सी कोशिश है इस शॉर्ट फिल्म से।
अमेजिंग विवान, आपसे जानना चाहेंगे इस कैरेक्टर के लिए आपने कितना अपने आप को प्रेप किया?
काफ़ी प्रेप करना पड़ा एक्चुअली, मेनली कल्पना के साथ जो हम इमेजिन करते हैं कि जो सिचुएशन जो है इसकी, तो उसके दौरान आई थिंक ज़्यादातर इमेजिनेशन से ही करना पड़ा, क्योंकि असल में जाके सच्ची में हीरोइन नहीं खींच सकता हूँ, लेकिन बहुत ही जैसे मैंने पहले कहा कि बहुत ही कथार्टिक और इमोशनल एक्सपीरियंस रहा पूरी फिल्म बनाने के दौरान, बहुत ही, और मॉरेलिटी प्ले, इट्स अ मॉरेलिटी प्ले इन अ सेंस दैट कि ऑडियंस को फैसला बनाना है कि क्या गलत और क्या सही, और यू नो दैट वे डीनो इज द मॉरल सेंटर एंड आई थिंक बोथ ऑफ अस रिप्रेजेंट डिफरेंट साइड्स ऑफ राइट एंड रॉन्ग, तो दैट्स द अमेजिंग पार्ट ऑफ द फिल्म दैट इट लीव्स द वो फैसला जो है वो ऑडियंस पे छोड़ जाती है।
विवन देखा जाता है फिल्म, व्हाट वाज डिड नसीर साहब हैव सीन द फिल्म?
यस,
ही, व्हाट इज हिज रिएक्शन स्पेशली ऑन योर परफॉर्मेंस?
ही लव्ड इट, ही लव्ड द फिल्म, ही वाज रियली मूव्ड बाय द फिल्म, बोथ माय पेरेंट्स, दे इन फैक्ट माय मदर इन पर्टिकुलर शी वाज रियली मूव्ड, एंड इवन माय डैड, ही रियली लव्ड द फिल्म, ही वाज वेरी अफेक्टेड बाय इट इमोशनली।
What are you apprehensive, you know, doing after doing the film like, you know, Dilwale and all, now doing absolutely something different? What are you apprehensive before coming on board?
No, not at all. Just when Niranjan only just messaged me, I was just so, I've been waiting to work with him, and this was a great opportunity. Like, I really consider myself to be like a student of Niranjan. He is someone who has an extraordinary erudition and wisdom about not just cinema, but also about art and about life. And it was just a joy to work with him and to work with everybody.
Okay, what else is happening on the professional front?
On the professional front, this is one. No. Unfortunately, no.
Unfortunately,
life is not that exciting. So there's this movie coming along. Hopefully, it's going to start soon. It's called Court, in which I have to play the role of a villager. So that's why I had to become really malnourished and thin and be like a mazdoor, is like a laborer. So ek mahine ke liye, in fact, main ek farm pe jaake, maine kheti baadi kaafi ki aur prepare ki. Basically, jo mazdoori, physical labor karna pada to prepare karne ke liye.
Would be a commercial masala film?
No, it's not a commercial. It's actually. I think it's first is going to go to a couple of festivals and all. It's a very small budget film.
Agricultural film.
Agriculture. It's an agricultural film. It's like.
Thank you guys, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.